because I want listeners to be able to take advantage of this opportunity. He bought a bunch of gold and silver a month ago when the globalists artificially driven it down, but the 10-year graph, it's going straight up. We knew it would go right back up. We've got the inside sources, plus they're devaluing the currency. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to know this. And so Ted told me this morning, he said he is going to run out very soon on the very best gold and silver deals he has, because when he runs out of that, then he's got to charge you, you know, for what he has bought the new gold and silver for at a higher price. And he's a big broker, so he gets a good deal regardless, but the deals he's got right now are off the chart, and I want people to get into gold and silver. If it's one silver coin, one gold coin, whatever the case is, it's time to move into it today. Gold and silver skyrocketing again. Oil up 9% in just the first few hours of today. Ted, where is gold and silver right now?
Well, gold hit a high today of, let me just take a quick peek here, just take, see if it went. Okay, 1407.60, and silver hit a high today of 33.48. Gold right now is at 1399.70. Silver right now at 32.91. I mean, it is strong, out of this world, off the charts. I mean, you call it what you want. With the Libyan crisis going on and oil prices shooting up through the roof, obviously that bodes very well for precious metals. I mean, $97, your three videos, some silver dollars. I don't know how people can just beat that. I mean, first of all, silver is well over into the 30s now. There's three silver dollars in there alone, and this is less than 30 bucks. You just can't, you know, a piece, $97 delivered. When you multiply it by three, obviously that's going to be a higher number than that. But anyways, the franc coins at 1308, the British sovereigns at 1386, walking liberties at 1576 now. There's so much pressure on the bottom side of this market. It's pressing things forward. People really need to be getting involved in the gold and silver. Obviously, this whole Middle Eastern thing looks like the makings for World War III. And I gotta hope it don't go there. But, the United States has got this printing press running on our shores. We've got this war going on and a complete collapse in the Middle East. Oil prices rising, inflation in China. It's like this perfect storm economically. And, all that stuff has upward pressure for gold. And we're seeing that right now.
To be clear, you get three silver dollars that are trading for basically $34 a piece right now. So that is above $100 to get three in the open market. Three of those for $97 with the shipping included, and Obama Deception Fall the Republic Endgame, a $60 value. So that's over a $70 discount on top of it on that silver dollar deal. But I hope when folks call, they'll get some of the other great gold coins. You've got Buffaloes. You've got the Ron Paul gold coins that just came in. You've got so many other great things out there. 800-686-2237. Ted had the biggest response he's ever had yesterday, by the way, breaking all records and phone calls. So if it's busy, leave your name and number. They'll call you back, or you can call tonight. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. Tell them it's the Alex Jones radio special to get the price from a month ago. And Ted, you told me you're running out. How long can you offer these deals?
Well, I'm going to hold it till midnight tonight, and I have to watch and see, because I have to look and see what my inventory looks like and what the markets are like in the morning. But I would doubt that I'm going to be able to hold it for that.
That's right. You're not like a lot of other gold brokers who get your order and then go out and buy the gold. You've got it all right there. That's why it ships so fast. 800-686-2237. I'd say purchase it from Ted and support the network, but I happen to know he makes almost no money on this, so it's just a great deal. Ted's crazy. 800-686-2237. Do the math. Great job, Ted. Thank you.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, A solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
The poets tell how Poncho fell and left his living in a cheap hotel. The desert's quiet, Cleveland's cold. So the story ends, we're told. Poncho needs your prayers, it's true. To save a few for Lefty, too. He only did what he had to. He's growing old.
To Alaska in 1971 as a missionary. The Trans-Alaska Oil Pipeline began its construction phase in 74, and because of Mr. Williams' love for his country and concern for the spiritual welfare of the pipeliners, he volunteered, he's also a pilot there flying people, to serve as a chaplain on the pipeline with the subsequent full support of the Alaska Pipeline Company. Because of the executive status accorded to him as chaplain, he was given access to information documented in his eye-opening book, The Energy Non-Crisis, unfortunately out of print. Because to understand what's happening now, you got to read that book. And everything in that book from 1980 that caused oil execs to get fired, you name it, now it's all plain view admitted. After numerous public speaking engagements in Western states, certain government officials or concerned individuals urged Williams to put into print what he saw and heard, stating that they felt this information was vital to national security. And actually, Ken Frum actually helped him rewrite the book. He wrote part of it. That was the Atlantic Richfield head of operations. Mr. Williams firmly believes that whoever controls energy controls the economy, thus the energy non-crisis. Now, Ken Frum died back around Christmas of cancer. We can now say it's Ken Frum. I knew it was Ken Frum. So did other people like Dr. Stan Monteith. Monteith's the type to not, even though he believes Williams to go off what he's saying, he went and figured it out and called him himself. He's also talked to the other guy who's living, was a former oil company CEO, Big Three, and there's been a strategic plan. And as we go to Lindsey, I want to break it down to you this way. Zygmunt Brzezinski writes books saying they work in 25 and 50 year plans. David Rockefeller, in his book he wrote 5 years ago, where he admits they want world government. I forget the name of it. Will you Google David Rockefeller's autobiography? I want to put it on screen. It's a side shot of him on the cover. We've got it back there. But on page 435, he talks about how, yes, we're going to get rid of sovereignty. Yes, we're going to do this. But they talk about 25 and 50-year plans. And an example of that, because the general public has been taught, oh, Wall Street thinks in quarters. No, they get you to think in quarters, so you're blind to the larger geopolitical, neo-feudalistic, neo-mercantile system that is the New World Order. But in the 70s was a key catalyst for the next 50-year plan. That's when these decisions were made. And I've read Rockefeller, I've read Kissinger, I've read Brzezinski basically say almost everything, but in a veiled way, that Lindsey's been told. That's the key. I can verify all this separately. Just Williams is directly talking to these folks. Now, and the info Lindsey gives us mirrors what we get from inside Bilderberg. But here's an example. I'm listening to WOAI this weekend, and they had a newscast about the 50-year water plan for Texas with the federal and state government and how we were 20-something years into the last plan and they're going to reassess it and launch a new 50-year plan off the old plan for water wells, reservoirs, desalinization plants on the coast, on and on and on, and how the federal government's doing tests right now with desalinization of saltwater aquifers as a test as part of the 50-year plan. We are on 50-year time frames with subsets of 25, where sometimes they readjust or reassess. And so talking to Williams last night, I'm going to give him the floor here in a moment, when he briefed me on this, everything he was saying, again, was already public intelligence, but they were filling in the missing pieces. What Williams wrote about in 1980, about the secret deals with Kissinger and the Arabs to buy T-bills, and how at a time in the future, they would shift to the global currency. That's in Trilateral Commission documents from 1975. But people would laugh at Williams about that. Now all of the previous part of the plan is public. He's going to give you the rest of the plan and what the globalists are telling him is going to unfold. Now, remember, Lindsey Williams was here in October, in November, in December. And in October, on record, we wrote articles about it, oil in the next year, 6 months to a year, to go to 150 to 200. Turmoil in the Middle East, not even so much war. He said they told me turmoil. That's on record. Destabilization campaign. And that would then lead to quote, China, watch the big one. Now the other big oil company, former CEO, is giving him the full breakdown of this program in the Middle East, what it's going to do in the U.S., what it's going to do in Asia, and the rest of the globalist blueprint and layout for what is about to happen in the next several years and the decade preceding it or following it. And so now, Lindsey Williams, I'm going to attempt to give you the floor. And in fact, you're going to be hosting the show, at least for this segment and the next. I'll take you out at break, but I'm going to actually go in the control room, only way I can control myself. And I'm going to be in there taking notes on points and questions I have for you. But I sat there for 30, 45 minutes with you last night and just shut up while you talked. And it was 10 times more powerful than anything we've ever done on the radio before. Lay it out. Let's start at the beginning.
Alex, you're a gentleman. Thank you so very much. Crude oil this morning is up $8 a barrel. Libya, the capital city, Tripoli, is burning. The capital building in Libya is on fire right now. Gaddafi is in power since 1969. And this morning, light, sweet crude oil is $108 a barrel. I have been told that it's going to 150.